Hello students, let us begin sums related to our next topic, that is interest coverage ratio. Here I'll share hints related to question number 61 to question number 65. Now let us first write the formula for this interest coverage ratio. What is the formula for this? Interest coverage ratio is equals to net profit before interest and tax divided by interest on long term debts. Now see question number 61, what it is saying, if net profit before, see what we, this is more important, before. Always remember that what we require is net profit before interest and tax. And here also what we are given, if net profit before interest and tax is 5 lakh and interest on long term funds is 1 lakh, find interest coverage ratio. So this is very simple. I have already solved some related to this in previous video. What you will do, you will just divide because both of the data are given to you. Okay. So now next question, what it is saying, see. Question number 62, from the following information calculate interest coverage ratio, net profit after tax. Here what it is given, please always make sure that net profit, what do we require is net profit before tax. So check in the question what you are given, before or after. Here what you are given, after. Net profit after tax is rupees 1,70,000, tax 30,000, interest on long term funds is rupees 50,000. You have to learn one format also. See, whenever you are given after tax, profit after tax, there's a calculation behind that. Now see, what is a calculation? There's always profit before tax and interest and tax. Okay. Whatever the amount is, and then from that interest is deducted, less interest, and after you'll get profit before tax. Okay, after deducting interest you'll get profit before tax. From here tax is deducted and then you get profit after tax. So whenever profit after tax is given, always you have to think that yes, from that interest is also deducted, because reaching till profit after tax, there's a format which you have to follow. First you have to subtract interest and then you have to subtract the tax. So if you are given net profit after tax, that means from there that profit interest is also deducted already. Okay, so here we are given interest after tax, but for our formula what do we require? Profit before tax. So for question number 62 we'll find profit before tax. So what we'll do, we'll add back the tax. Okay, profit before tax and interest, and interest, to find that what we'll do, we'll add back interest and tax to profit after tax. So I'm writing PAT, that is profit after tax, plus interest plus tax. Then only you'll get your profit before tax, because after in profit after tax, interest and tax both are deducted. So if you if you'll add back them, you'll get your profit before tax. So interest after tax is given to us as 1,70,000. So we'll add 1,70,000 here, plus interest is given to us, interest on long term debts. Here also interest, always remember, on long term debts. Okay. So interest on long term debts is given to us as 50,000. So we'll add 50,000 here, plus tax is given to us as 30,000. So we'll add 30,000 here. So 1,70,000 plus 30,000, 2 lakh, plus 50,000, you'll get your answer as 2,50,000. Now you got your profit before tax and interest as 2,50,000, and you, for that you got this, and you are already having interest on long term debts as 50,000. So divide and you'll get your answer. Okay, now coming to next question, that is question number 63. See what it is saying, from the following details calculate interest coverage ratio, net profit after, again what it is given, after is given to us, net profit after tax rupees 7 lakh, 6% debentures 20 lakh, tax rate 30%. again what you have to find here is profit before tax, okay? And here interest is not directly given to you, but you can find it out because see, this 6% is nothing but interest rate of this. That means 6% of 20 lakh will be your interest on debentures or long term debts. So 6% will be your interest on these long term debts. This long term debt is 20 lakh and 6% is its interest rate. Okay. So again, let us find profit before tax. For question number 63, what we are given, profit after tax, I'm writing. That is, you are not allowed to use these short forms. Again, I'm saying. So that is given to us as 7 lakh. Now, if I want interest on long term debt, that will be 6% because that interest rate is already given to us. So 6% of 20 lakh. So you'll get it as 1,20,000. Now you got your interest, but what about tax? Here we were directly given the amount of tax, but we are not given amount of tax, but what we are given here is interest rate of that tax is given to us. So we have to again find it out. Now see, profit after tax here is the amount after deducting the tax, right? So if I say I have this amount as 7 lakh and this as 30%, why 30%? Here it is given as 30%. This as 30%. So this is after deducting. So what will be this amount and this amount? Let it be 100. Okay. If tax if profit before tax is 100, I am subtracting 30% from that. I'll get it as 70%. I'll again repeat this. See, you are given tax rate as 30%. So assume profit before tax as 100%. From that 100%, if you deduct 30% of tax, you'll get it as 70%, and that 70% amount is given to you as 7 lakh. Okay, so here you can write it as profit after tax is 70%, and that is 7 lakh, right? Now, if this is 7 lakh, what is 100%? Why I'm taking 100%? Because I want profit before tax. Okay, so what will be 100%? If you cross multiplication, you'll get your answer as 10 lakh, right? Now, you got your profit. This is profit before tax. But you don't require only profit before tax. What you require is profit before tax and interest. This is only profit before tax. So you're also having interest, right? So what we'll do, we'll add this to get profit before interest and tax. Okay, so profit before interest and tax will be, we are having profit before tax plus interest. You're having profit before tax as what? You're having it as, let us check, we have got it. You're having 10 lakh, okay? So 10 lakh plus interest is given. We have found out interest also. See here, 1,20,000 interest on long term debt, that is 1,20,000. So add 1,20,000, okay? So you'll get it as 11,20,000. So here you got 11,20,000 as your profit before interest and tax, correct? Now what we require for our formula, profit before interest and tax divided by interest on long term debts. Okay, you're having profit before interest and tax as 11,20,000 and interest on long term debt as 1,20,000. So divide this and you'll get your answer. That will be around 9.33. okay, now starting with next question, let us check what it is. Question number 64, it says net profit after tax. Again, what we are given here is after interest and tax, that is 1,20,000, rate of income tax 40%, 15% debentures, this is our long term debt, that is 1 lakh, and 12% mortgage loan, this is also our long term debt, that is 1 lakh. So we are having two long term debts, and see, this 15% is interest rate, this 12% is also interest rate. So we can find out the interest on long term debts, right? Let us find question number 64, interest on long term debts is equals to, one is interest on debenture, and another is plus interest on loan. Okay, we have took a loan, so we'll add this both. Now there were two things, so first of all let us see what it is. 15% of debenture, that is 15% of 1 lakh. Okay, so we'll find out 15% of 1 lakh plus next is 12% of 1 lakh. So we'll write down 12% of 1 lakh. So 15% of 1 lakh will give us 15,000 plus 12% of 1 lakh, 12,000. And if you add this both, 15 plus 12,000 will give you 27,000. So you got your interest on long term debts. But again, what we are given here is profit after. We are given profit after interest and tax. Again, tax is deducted from this and tax rate is 40%. So again, that thing we can do, profit before tax less tax and profit after tax. Now, profit after tax is given to us as 1,20,000. We are given tax rate as 40%. So what we'll do, profit before tax will assume as 100%, right? Now if 40, and this will be 100 minus 60 will give you 60%. Again, if 60% is 1,20,000, what is 100% will show? 60% is 1,20,000. So 100% is how much amount? Cross multiply, you'll get your answer as 2 lakh. Okay, so profit before tax is here, you can add down the interest, so you'll get down get your profit before interest and tax, and then you can again apply the formula. The steps will be same like this after this. Okay, now let us begin our last sum of this video. Question number 65, from the following information calculate interest coverage ratio. What you are given here is equity shares, 8% preference shares, 10% debentures is given to us. So this is our long term debt. Long term loans and from bank, that is again our long term debt. Interest on long term loans from bank, that means interest on this is given to us as 5,000. Net profit after tax is given to us, and already tax is given to us. So from here you can find out net profit before tax. Okay, so let us begin working for that. Question number 65. Now first of all, what we require, profit after tax is given to us, let us find profit before tax. So formula for that will be profit before tax is equals to profit after tax plus tax. Okay, now profit after tax is given to us as 75,000 and tax is given to us as 9,000. So 75,000 plus 9,000 will give you 84,000. Okay, now you got this, but what for our formula we require profit before tax and interest. So here we'll also require interest on long term loans and advances. So let us see how many long term loans and advances are we having. See, debentures and this long term loans from bank, both are long term loans and advances. So, and this 10% is what? Rate of interest. So debentures are 10%, that is 50,000 is your debenture. So interest on debenture will be 10% of 5,000, and here for interest on long term loans from bank is already given to us. So interest on long term loans and advances is equals to 10% of 50,000, sorry, and plus 5,000 is already given to us. This will be 5,000 plus 5,000, so interest will be 10,000. So you can get profit before interest and tax as profit before tax plus interest, okay, and profit before tax we have found it as 84,000 plus total interest of 10,000, so you'll get it as 94,000. Now for your formula, you got profit before interest and tax and divided by interest on long term loan, that is 10,000 you are already having, and you can find out the answer. With this we'll complete this topic of interest coverage ratio. I hope this hints will help you to solve the sums. Thank you.